Hello, everyone. The heavens opened earlier, and the rain shows no inclination to stop. We're looking forward to the game anyway. My name is Derek Ray. With me in the commentary box is Arsenal legend Lee Dixon. And we're ready to bring you live coverage of this League One fixture. It's Lincoln City, and they take on Bolton Wanderers.
Yeah, thanks, Derek. Looking forward to a bright, lively start in this one. Quick tempo. Who can be the dominant force in the first 20 minutes? They could get the upper hand in this one.
This is the lineup for the home team. Well, as a team, they do have their stylistic preference, and it really is all about trying to put the opposition under pressure, making sure that they don't compose themselves. Lee, do you expect to see more of that in this game?
Yeah, pretty much. They love to press high, don't they? It's their preferred style of play, winning the ball high up the pitch. It certainly benefits their strikers. They're very good at it.
And here's the starting lineup for Bolton Wanderers. An element of caution about this selection.
Yeah, 4-5-1, Derek. The five players behind the lone striker will need to support him. Looks a very strong midfield offensively and also defensively. The back four will be protected throughout the game.
Thank you. Enjoy the game.
And this confrontation is underway. Grant. Well, he went strongly into the challenge, and the result is a throw-in. Splendid tackle, and a throw-in coming up. Grant. The cross is on. Couldn't hang on to it. News of a goal at Fratton Park. Alan McAnally can tell us more.
It's a goal for Portsmouth. 5 minutes played, 1-0.
Regular updates from Alan McAnally along the way. Buckley. Murphy. And that is offside. Buckley. Gone for power, Lee, but it's wide.
Well, no real direction, but the power was there, and you're right, it's just gone past the post.
I believe there's been a goal on the Doncaster Rovers match. Alan McAnally can tell us all about it.
It's a goal for Doncaster Rovers. 16 minutes played, 1-1.
Alan McAnally keeping us right up to date. Hamilton. And he has just veered into an offside position this time. Thirdly. Giving the ball away. Crossing possibilities. Will he finish? And a goal is it is, the opener in this game.
Well, keep it tight, that's what both managers would have been saying. But now the opening goal's gone in, tactics have got to change. Well, here we can see, Derek, from this better angle, it's all about the technique. When you're volleying a ball, it's all about timing. Let it get to the right place for your foot to make the connection, and there you go, in the back of the net.
So the match has restarted, 1-0 here. Murphy, given away. Far from a good pass. And they'll have to throw it back in play. Anderson. Sheehan. Eardley. An important interception. He's given us away. Might really be able to trouble them here. Now just couldn't keep the ball. Hamilton. Trying his luck from long range. And the defender got the last touch. That'll be a corner. He's driven in the corner. Well, he had a decent reading of that ball in. Now he must favour the cross. He takes aim. It's still alive. I'm hearing that there's been a goal in one of the other matches. Who is it for, Alan McInally?
It's a goal for Bristol Rovers. 42 minutes played. 1-1.
Many thanks, Alan. And Siala. Murphy. The referee's verdict is 3 additional minutes. They really look after the ball when they have it. Well, you've got to conclude that it was completely overhit. Sheehan. The first half here comes to an end. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Buckley, Murphy. They've given it away. Keep it. And news of a goal in the Doncaster game. Alan McInally.
It's a second goal for Doncaster Rovers. 51 minutes played. 2-1.
Alan McInally with his finger on the pulse. Space on the flank. Well, the cross goes in, but there's no one available to snap onto it. Not problematic for the keeper. Not a good pass. And he takes on the shot. Tremendous block. Murphy. It is a decent looking attack here. Straight at the goalkeeper then. Right, let's go to Alan McInally, because I hear there's been a goal in the Coventry game. Alan.
It's a goal for Coventry City. 62 minutes, please. 1-1.
Alan McInally keeping us right up to date. Giving the ball away. Cross fired over. Grant. And given away. Murphy. Buckley. And that's an important intervention.
With Alan Keegan. That's Alan Keegan. Please come to reception.
A chance to whip it in. Well, a respectable enough effort, but he couldn't extend the lead.
Given too much space, why not take the shot on? Good effort.
Well, we can now go to Alan McInally for news of a goal elsewhere. Alan, and he's made headway.
Well, Derek, the clock is ticking. The crowd are doing their bit, trying to get the players forward to try and get this goal.
Sincere apologies to Alan McInally, because we had to cut him off just when he was in his flow. To recap, the hosts did score in that game, and they're winning in that game at the moment by 2-1. Murphy.
Well, they haven't been at their best today, that's for sure, but this game is far from over, and the fans are certainly reminding them of that. You've got to think there'll be one more chance or two.
And the ball's gone. Anderson. 5 minutes remaining, and one thing is certain, no one is leaving, because it's still close. After the foul, a chance to contemplate what is next, and perhaps a goal from this free kick. Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change. And the goalkeeper not offering any scraps that time. Well, they've lost possession of the ball.
The fourth official won it back. Of 2 minutes of added time.
They've given it away. Effective challenge. And there goes the final whistle. Possibilities. Will he finish? And a goal it is, the opener in this game.
Well, keep it tight, that's what both managers would have been saying. But now the opening goal's gone in, tactics have got to change. No!
my mind and I'm losing control, but you know that I love them. And I feel like I'm ready to give and I'm ready to love and you know that you want them. And I gave you my word and I show you my word, but you don't understand that I love you. If it mean that you try, it's a mean that you lie, then it mean that you hide, then you the baby.
Palabra cachita. our main feature today on EA TV. Two great clubs. It's coming up for you live. Perfect pitch on a perfect day in this stadium. I'm Martin Tyler, Alan Smith is with me. We are at the round of 16 stage in the Carabao Cup. Preston North End against Bolton Wanderers.
Yeah, starting to get towards the business end of this competition now. And cup matches are always, they always have a different flavour to league contests. So I'm expecting a really good match here.
Number 16, Andrew Hughes. Number 4, Ben Pearson. Number 8, Alan Brown. Number 29, Tom Barkhuizen. Number 31, Scott Sinclair.
Here's the Preston team for you. Looking at the lineup, he's got all the components in place, hasn't he? The manager for the pressing style of play that's been a feature of his team.
Yep, and many an opponent has found it difficult to cope with. If your touch isn't spot on against this aggressive type of closing down, you're going to lose it in dangerous areas.
Let's have a look at the way Bolt Wanderers are going to play today with these players. Responsibility for some of those five in midfield to get forward, and I'm sure the main striker won't be isolated, although it looks a bit like that on our screens.
Yeah, he could be a lonely man up top there if he doesn't get the support that he needs, because he is the type of player that does need support. He can't do it all on his own.
Pearson, Paul Gallagher. He wants to run at them with the ball. It's good to see. Goalkeeper will get this one, no problem. That's very good shielding of the ball. Can find some space here on the flanks. Really good chance, no one on him. Well, here could be a chance for the corner. Put in the corner, got to get it over the first man defending, and they haven't done that from the corner. Now that's a throw.
On to Buckley.
Good width in the attack here, looking for a cross at the end of it, and the defender is there to clear it. Back in possession of the ball. Lovely. Left the defenders trailing now. Here's a chance. No offside here for the goalkeeper. He's done very well in that one-on-one.
Well, it was a battle of wits almost, wasn't it? And the keeper didn't commit himself, stayed on his feet, asked the question of the attacker.
Swung in from the corner. No threat now. Reading of the by anticipating the pass. Throw in to come. Low. A try one now. Well, he's knocked it in. Got the lead now. It hasn't come easily, but they're delighted with it. It was a well-crafted move and a fine finish at the end of it.
Well, he's just feathered that into the right-hand side. That is a wonderful take.
Another angle on it here.
So that goal has put Bolton Wanderers into the lead. Read that well with the interception. Promising build-up until that challenge. Pearson. Fisher. Well, that'll be a throw. And it's got Nsiala. Goes for goal. Got to do better than that, really, to beat the keeper.
Yeah, because he is a good goalkeeper. Good positioning.
And in it goes. Very good positioning by the defender. Low. Tried his luck. A touch over the bar. The corner for Bolton Wanderers. That's a fine shot, an even better save.
Yeah, because it was sweetly struck, and you do have to pay attention to those.
Corner swung in. Shot blocked here. Murphy. That's an important clearance.
Out is Dr. Nsiala.
Looks for shoot.
Fantastic save.
Put the corner in the middle.
It's not really away. Poor clearance.
Well, then it goes.
That's a very weak cross from a very good position.
Looking to create an opening. And in the shot go!
I think that hit the post, Alan. I think it did. Just clipped it. So unlucky.
Hughes.
The referee has indicated,
and it's going to be a minimum of 3 minutes to be played of added time. Gallagher. Squandering possession cheaply, really, with that pass. Well, that's half-time at 1-0. Well, this could be the halfway point in the cup tie, and we've got one team leading with a chance of progressing in this tournament. Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start. Low. Slipping it through. Players trying to attack the cross. Oh, what a touch by the defender.
He was so quick to get into position, to get his body in the way there.
Corner played into the middle.
In the crowd of players, the keeper goes for a punch.
Sinclair. Sharp in the tackle. It'll be a throw now. Scott Sinclair. Well, now they've got the ball, what are they going to do with it? The home team about to make a change. It's got him out of a tight area with that back heel. That's how to tackle. They've been trying to do this, get the ball over the top.
There's time for a clearance from the cross.
Well, we're two-thirds of the way through the 90 minutes, half an hour to go.
Now he wants to take them on.
Well, it will be a throw. It's gone out off that player there. One of the backup brigade is going to have a chance centre stage. Brown. Excellent interception. Well, they've got the opposition on the back foot with this break. They're coming at them with numbers. Put in from the wide area. He worked hard to get the cross in, but it didn't reach any of his teammates arriving in the middle. Maguire made sure the pass wasn't completed. Really good chance, no one on him. Oh, they thought they were in, but the flag has gone up. Well, the losing team have got to do something, and this is it, the substitution. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. That would be a throw.
With the owner of the silver hatchback with the license plate GR,
now Hughes.
JKK, please contact the nearest security guard. Thank you.
It goes out wide again. Keeping the ball is one thing, but they've got to try and open up the opposition. And on the home bench, a substitute is clearly getting ready to come on.
He's confident with the ball at his feet, isn't he?
Tried to find the winning ticket in the raffle, but the number's short.
Yes. He took it early, though. I don't know if they can turn this around. Their creative players have not been at the party, really, today. Not been able to create the chances they normally do.
Is Dr. Siala. Going forward with real purpose now. Hamilton. The goalkeeper to the rescue.
Well, it's one against one, and this keeper's got a good track record in those situations.
Put the corner in the middle.
Put away, but not out of harm's way. Hamilton. That hasn't troubled the keeper.
The supporters, Alan, trying to play their part here and lift the home team.
Yeah, I think they believe, Martin. The question is, do they?
Surely! It's bounced back off the bar. Two more minutes to be played then, added time.
2 minutes of added time.
Now Fisher. Brown. Well, it could lead to the equaliser. This later on, they won't have many more.
Final score here, 1-0.
Well then, cup ties, winning is all that matters, and they have won.
Yeah, they've done the necessary.
Can you hear me now? Oh God, are you giving me
Hi everyone, it is an absolutely splendid day for football and we're looking forward to the game. I'm Derek Ray, joined by Lee Dixon in the commentary position. And coming up for you very shortly, live action from League One. It's Bolton Wanderers and they face Fleetwood Town.
Cheers, Derek. Yeah, really excited about this one. Looking forward to some entertaining end-to-end football.
Well, you can probably see why we're focusing on this fellow as one to watch. Lee, in particular, what do you expect to see from his game?
Well, he's added goals to his wizardry. Will he get another goal today, a brace in his last match?
And here's the starting lineup for Bolton Wanderers. Fairly conventional 4-5-1 setup.
Yeah, that back four will be protected throughout the game with the five midfield players in front of them. Really important that they do support that lone striker when they do have the ball.
Thank you.
This is how the visitors will set up today. The emphasis perhaps on keeping things tight at the back, Lee.
Yeah, I really like this system. Very fluid look about it. It can be five at the back when you haven't got the ball, but those wing-backs can push into midfield to make a 3-4-3 formation. The width supplied by the wingers to a lone striker.
Hamilton. Looks promising. Goalkeeping right out of the top drawer.
I cannot believe he's kept that out the net. Absolutely amazing.
And firing it into the area. And cleared behind for what is going to be a corner kick. Well, here's the table, and Portsmouth fans were full of optimism at the start, but not quite so optimistic now, because it's not really happening, is it?
Well, the start of the season, most pundits, commentators, myself included, thought that...
He takes aim. Well, he analyses it, you know. I think he'll feel he shouldn't have taken on the shot from there.
Well, he definitely shouldn't have done. The angle's all wrong. He's got to look for other options.
A change to the scoreline, I believe, in the Blackpool game. Let's hear all about it from Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Blackpool. 9 minutes played, 1-0.
Thanks, Alan. Really good reading of the game to win possession back. Well, pressing high is something the visitors like to do. It can take a lot out of any team, but it is very much their game. Lee, would you expect that approach this time?
Yeah, absolutely. The press looks on the way the team's set up. High energy is needed for this tactic. Everyone has to buy into it, but the rewards are big, Derek.
Well, they're on the scent of something positive. Andrew. Options in the centre. A fine block. Wonderfully weighted pass. That's all they can conjure for now. Hill just can't seem to get out of their own half, and that's down to the pressure. It's with Joe Bunny. And he's made headway. The opening goal, due reward for their efforts.
Well, they've made the pressure count. They really deserve this lead. Well, look at it again. I do question the defenders, but let's give credit to him. What a wonderful solo effort. And he still has the presence of mind to finish it off. What a brilliant solo goal.
The opening goal of the game then. News of a goal on the Rotherham United match. Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Rotherham United. 25 minutes played. 1-0.
Opportunity it is. The offside flag had to go up, and it did.
Yeah, look along the line. Look along the line.
Paul Coutts on the ball. And they will be awarded a free kick for that. And no problems whatsoever for the goalkeeper. Well, there's been a goal elsewhere. Alan McAnally with the latest.
It's a second goal for Burton Albion. 31 minutes played. 2-1.
Cheers again, Alan. Possession lost. An important interception. And given away. What can he do from here? Running towards goal. Oh, he's found the net. And that increases the advantage to 2. Just what they wanted and just what they deserve.
Well, let's look at this again. We've all hit these in training. First time, bang in the back of the net. Look at the calmness of it. Technique, brilliant.
Well, let's take another look at that goal, shall we? So, 2-0 now. Burns. Evans. Paul Coutts on the ball. The referee's verdict is 3 additional minutes. Hamilton. Buckley. And with that, the first half draws to a close. The teams are ready to have a go at each other again as the second half commences. Hamilton. He's in with a chance. It really is such a free-scoring performance. Just nothing the defenders can do about it, seemingly.
Well, he had enough time to think about it, didn't he? He knew what he was going to do and did it brilliantly.
Well, it's been such a one-sided game. You just wonder how many more they could add. Getting forward. That's excellent defending following the cross. And a goal has gone in at Fratton Park. To tell us more, Alan McAnally.
It's a goal for Portsmouth. 53 minutes played. 1-0.
Alan McAnally with his finger on the pulse. Well, they've been getting the substitute ready, and now they will make the personnel change. Illegal play, and hence a free kick. Lowe. Jason Lowe with it. Nsiala. Delaney. Hamilton. Read it superbly to take back possession. Half an hour remaining then. So a throw in here. I'm hearing that there's been a goal in one of the other matches. Who is it for, Alan McAnally?
It's a third goal for Burton Albion. 62 minutes played, 3-1.
Thanks as ever for the update, Alan. No worries for the keeper.
Silver hatchback with the registration GR21LJJ. Please come.
And the emphasis is on creativity. Over the touchline for a throw-in. Jason Lowe with it. O'Grady. And now, passing it through. Now, will they do it from here? Well, it's a procession of goals. And surely there's no way they can let this slip now. Absolutely dominant.
Well, here's the replay. Sometimes keepers use those posts as a part of their defence, but not on that occasion. In off the woodwork.
And we're underway again. This game very much over as a contest. Paul Coutts on the ball. Morris going well. Great strong tackle. Throw in forthcoming. He could pick out a teammate. Fruitful looking attack. Quick thinking to dispossess his opponent. O'Grady. News of a goal on the Rotherham United match. Alan McAnally.
It's a third goal for Rotherham United. 79 minutes played. 3-0.
Many thanks, Alan. Will he play it in? Low trajectory ball there. That is excellent pressure high up the pitch. Gliding through the gears. A poor cross, all things considered. Poor attempt at a pass, really. Has a go. Staunch rearguard action. And the counter looks on here. Options available. Well, they seem to be onto something positive, but it faded away. Can he make it count? Absolutely magnificent goalkeeping.
Oh, he's almost turning away. He thinks he's scored. The goalkeeper doesn't.
Well, thumps clear. It's with Giovanni, just straying offside. And just the 1 minute left in normal time here. Low. O'Grady. A very good tackle. And there it is, the final whistle.
Don't know you, don't you? All these old.